Flat earthers are terrified of curves. Curved lines, curved surfaces. They don't understand how it works, and they don't want to understand it, because it instantly kills their silly narrative of the earth being flat. Anthony Reilly, also known as Sleeping Warrior, has put another 2 cents in, and it's called Expressio Unius Est Exclusio Alterius. As usual, he doesn't understand it, but that doesn't prevent him from using it, or should I say, misusing it. He even made a video misusing it. It's called Straight Does Not Mean Curved, Expressio Unius Est Exclusio Alterius. Let's first look at what Expressio Unius Est Exclusio Alterius means. The literal translation of it is, expression of one is the exclusion of another. It's a concept that stems from the law. If the legislator specifically mentions only certain items from a larger class of items, it meant to include only the items specified and to exclude those items that were omitted. Here we find our first hurdle. It's a concept that is valid in law, but not necessarily in other fields. But these little trivialities don't keep Tony from applying it to anything he wants to. Bev, try thinking. Some minion of his has found a citation from the book The Elements by Euclid, the famous mathematician, that goes as follows.
Thing on another straight line makes the adjacent angles equal to one another. Each of the angles is called a right angle, and the straight line which stands on the other is called a perpendicular to it.
First of all, Tony's minion calls this statement a definition. A definition is a statement of the exact meaning of a word. It's an is statement. Even the pretender clown Quantum Eraser agrees with this. However, the citation isn't a definition. It's an if-then statement, also known as a conditional statement, that could be simplified as, if a straight line makes an angle of 90 degrees to another straight line, then the first straight line is called perpendicular to the second one. This alone makes the application of the whole expressio unius est exclusio alterius argument that Tony and his little helper are trying to pull off invalid. But let's see how Tony comes in.
This video is going to be about a Latin phrase. I'm probably going to butcher this, but it's pronounced along the lines of expressio unius exclusio alterius. I can't really pronounce it properly, it's on screen. It basically means that when you have something specifically mentioned, it's the exclusion of everything else that follows. But if it was blue lines, if it expressly said blue, you would agree that red lines wouldn't be covered.
Yes. So if it was just saying blue lines crossing one another, that doesn't exclude the possibility that red lines can do the same thing, similarly with curves.
But wouldn't it say blue and red?
Now he starts arguing that by the fact that it mentions a straight line, it excludes all other types of lines. As an example, he changes the word straight for blue. His position is that, in order to be applicable to red lines, the statement would have to include red lines, and therefore it would have to mention red lines also, not just blue lines. No one in his right mind would argue that when blue lines crossing each other at an angle of 90 degrees are called perpendicular to each other, it therefore is impossible for red lines crossing at an angle of 90 degrees to be called perpendicular to each other also. But Tony does think it is. That is exactly the reason why the real definition of perpendicular is formulated in more general terms. The real definition of perpendicular is standing at right angles to the plane of the horizon, exactly upright. Or being at right angles to a given line or plane. Or a more general one, a line at right angles to a line or plane as of the horizon. No mentioning of straight, no specifics as to what properties the line and the plane should have. The line could just as well be curved. The plane also could just as well be curved. And in fact, in geometry, curved lines can intersect straight lines. Curved lines, flat planes, and curved planes at a right angle, and therefore be called perpendicular. But let's be clear. If expressio unius est exclusio alterius would be valid in everyday life, or in any life other than that of a man of the law, normal communication would be virtually impossible. When a heavyweight boxer punches another heavyweight boxer, and the second heavyweight boxer goes down for more than 10 seconds, the first heavyweight boxer is called the winner over the second heavyweight boxer. Expressio unius est exclusio alterius. A lightweight boxer never can be a winner. When a triangle has sides 1, 1 and 1, it is called an equilateral triangle. Expressio unius est exclusio alterius. A triangle with sides 2, 2 and 2 cannot be called an equilateral triangle. Only triangles with sides 1, 1 and 1 can be called equilateral. And I could go on and on. Tony, you should stick to the law and leave geometry, mathematics, and in fact physics in general to those that understand it and probably can apply it. But to make things even worse, Tony couldn't resist adding another completely unnecessary mistake to the growing list of mistakes. Listen to this.
So what you need to take from this video is straight lines do mean straight lines. They do not mean curved lines. There's only two types of lines. There's curvy lines and the straight lines. If it expressly states straight lines, it means straight lines. It does not mean curved. Straight does not mean curved. So just as straight lines don't mean curvy lines, curvy lines don't mean straight neither. So when it says refraction, light travels in straight lines but varies from point to point to point, it doesn't mean that it follows a curved path. Oh dear. Goodbye refraction. Goodbye non-Euclidean geometry.
And as usual, Riley has only read a very small portion of the paper, or he just don't want us to see the rest of it. This is what's written right beneath the highlighted part. But all media are inhomogeneous, at some degree, with their different properties varying from point to point, and the atmosphere, of course, is no exception. When the medium is inhomogeneous, and the index of refraction changes continuously from point to point, the trajectory of light is affected at each differential step, not just at the boundary between two media. The final result of this differential change is a curved path that distorts the normal view of a real scene. I'll repeat that slowly. The final result of this differential change is a curved path that distorts the normal view of a real scene. Oh dear. Goodbye, Anthony Riley. Goodbye, Sleeping Warrior.